Hey kids. Hey kids of excellence, not victory. YouTube.com. So, in a previous show, we ended up with a whole bunch of chicken flavored ramen packets. Remember? Brown chicken, brown cow. Oh, you're so nasty. Yeah, I know. I still think it's freaking hilarious. So, we're going to take care of two recipes today that use these. Alright, so, we'll get to this later. Recipe number one, pretty simple. Dry roasted Planters peanuts. Put a little of those in a bowl. This is something that I put this stuff in Ziploc bags and carry it in my car. But maybe it's more of a entertainment. Like if you're having practice like Toddzilla has practice, and you put out food and snacks and stuff, and you get people that drive hours and hours and come and visit, as opposed to those people who have practice and don't put out snacks. But then they go, I wonder why nobody comes to practice every week. Tell you what, get on Facebook, contact Trinity, Raina Green, and Justin Green, and ask about practices at Toddzilla's house when we did blender drinks. I had as many women showing up to practice as I had guys. That was good time. Anyway, snacks are very important for a good arm wrestling practice. So what we did is we've got almonds, peanuts, and walnuts. The peanuts were dry roasted. The almonds, I like the smokehouse type almonds. I love those. I think these are awesome. Smokehouse, by the way. But the walnuts are for baking, so they're completely unseasoned. So what happens is the seasoning on the peanuts and on the walnuts are not enough to take care. The seasons on the peanuts and the almonds are not enough to season the walnuts. But you got dry roasted peanuts working in there, you got smoky almonds working in there, and then the walnuts have a dry, bitter type feeling for them. And you don't find walnuts in a lot of mixed nuts containers and stuff. So, what we do is, so you know this is excellence, not victory, and you know we love olive oil. Dribble a little olive oil over your nut mixture. You see how I carefully measured that? Because, you know, it's one thing you learn in engineering school is measuring is very, very important. And if it's one thing you learn in cooking school is, it's all about how you feel. And engineers love discussing feelings versus actual measurements and data like that. So anyway, so now a third of this is walnuts, which are unseasoned. And then I dumped a whole bunch of olive oil in there. And by a whole bunch, I mean like not nearly enough. But you guessed it. Whoo! Hey, baby. Brown chicky brown cow. So, take this. It's so much like high school. Dump that right in there. And what's great about this is it's salty enough, it seasons up the walnuts, balances everything. It works well with the smoky flavor of the almonds and the dry roasted peanuts. But your guests will love it, because everybody loves chicken-flavored ramen. But they're not expecting chicken-flavored ramen in their nut mix. And then the olive oil in there just adds a whole nother texture, and it gives it that, man, I should have researched this before. You guys who actually cook for a living and know, go ahead and explain it to me, but, or put it in the comments, please, because I'm just going to sound like an idiot trying to. Not that sounding like an idiot is something that bothers me, but I'm just going to say the wrong word, and then people are like screaming at their video saying, you mean to say, whatever. Oh yeah, see, now that walnut Now that walnut feels like it fell right from heaven. There you go. Oh. Mmm. That is so good. Now, you know what? You serve this after dinner, and all your kids are going to study harder, and they're all going to get on the honor roll, and they're going to kiss you goodnight, and they're going to say, I love you, Mom and Dad, and I'm going to try so hard, and I'm going to get into AP classes next year. That's so good. And it's good for you, I guess. I don't know. I'm not a nutritionist. It tastes good, though. But it wouldn't be a cooking show if we only did one thing. Well, it would be. It would just be a cooking show if we only did one thing. That's a recipe that's I mean, I like it. But I've been known to like weird things. Also, I'm trying very, very hard to talk more because I've been reading the comments in the video, and the other producers of Excellence Not Victory seem to talk more, but most of the comments on mine are they're saying, I wish they would talk more, and I go, man, I've been married for 24 years. Never once in my life did anybody say, honey, you should talk more. So, what we're gonna do now, good quality Indiana popcorn. Put all that in this bowl. This is mostly a demonstration video. And everybody's got good moms. My mom gave me this bowl 14 or 15 years ago. And I think I've used this bowl once a week for 15 years. This bowl is so cool. This isn't how the instructions came with it, but once again, boom, olive oil. A little olive oil in there. Oh, man. I should have done this before I did the other thing, because I'm about to have like several minutes of, oh my God. When they make the movie of this, it'll be so much better. Anyways, we're taking this. It's just raw popcorn and olive oil in the lid. We're gonna pop it right into the microwave. Now, I know all you kids are raising your hands. Do not like shout out the answer. All right, please just be patient. So while that's microwaving, I'm gonna put away my stuff. Whew, those are so good. I'm telling you right now, this is so good, I'm almost thinking about running a triathlon tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And learning a foreign language, like Mandarin. Oh! That is so good. I am telling you. I am changing the world here, man. I gave you the J&M presses. I introduced you to the Westside Barbell System, but you're all going to say, you know what? Chicken flavored nuts are like your greatest contribution. You can probably hear that popcorn popping. This is so good. We got a recipe coming up where we make chip dip, where we dump a bunch of like fresh ground pepper and bacon bacon bits into it. That's pretty good, but I'll tell you what, that nut mixture right there will, people say, man, I'm tired of eating that crap Chex Mix stuff those freaking weirdos serve me all the time. I'm like Toddzilla's chicken flavored walnut mix. But it's not Toddzilla's. It's Excellence Not Victories. Craig Andy Davis, Tyson Borman, Jimmy Baker, they're all contributors here. We got a few seconds left. You ever have like weird dreams anymore? God, man, I have this like recurring dream. Like I wake up and like it's finals week and I haven't been to class all year. And I'm trying to figure out why I didn't go to class, you know, because I'm like in my 50s. I go, why am I still in high school? How come I didn't go to class? And why am I buck naked running around through the freaking campus? Boom, look at that. Microwave popcorn, just like the Indians used to make. So, anybody guess what we're about to do? Easy there, Molly. Molly, can I please not always see the same hands? That's exactly right. But I'm going to give you a little mix right now, a little switcheroo. So obviously we're going to put that on. Okay? So for those of you following at home, you've tried this and you're saying, oh yeah, I want Todd to come speak at my wedding or my funeral. This is so good. But, and popcorn, how can you possibly improve on popcorn? What's so good about this is they will love this because it's salty, but it has that hint of a flavor they recognize but they can't quite place, and they will keep eating it trying to figure out. Which I guess I thought that meant you're a good hostess because they eat all your food, but maybe it just means you're a good puzzler or a torturer. Now I'm not so sure. Well, it's freaking delicious. But to kick it up again, poultry seasoning. I'm telling you, anything that's got chicken in it, you need to throw some poultry seasoning in. Poultry seasoning is mostly sage, which is, I don't know, it's either a witchcraft herb or it's that stuff that bounces around to the west. Anyway, sprinkle a little poultry seasoning on both of those. And your Top Fuel supercharged snacks just added another turbocharger and some nitrous oxide to it. That is so good. Now, but there's more. Why would you stop at just two spices if you could do three? This is where we're really going to go nuts. The nuts by themselves, the nut mix, the ramen noodles, and the poultry season is perfect. The popcorn, though. Poultry season, ramen noodle mix, pepper. Throw a little fresh ground pepper in there. Not a lot. Just enough to throw some little color into it. Mostly we're throwing the pepper in there to get the smell. The pepper smell. Pepper smell. Pepper, 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 pepper smell. Now, whoo! Oh! It's almost like Thanksgiving and Halloween went on a date and had a whole new baby holiday. That is so good. Okay. So, that wraps it up. If you have snack ideas of your own, please drop box them to us at excellencenotvictory@gmail.com. If you have an absolutely terrible joke that's funny once, that it's funny all the time, go ahead and put that in the comments. Hey, we love you guys. Thank you.